This is a very special occasion in joining Kiana and Jeff and the union of marriage. Jeff, you may now receive your bride and walk her forward, please. Now, Jeff and Kiana, the two of you have each had a separate path that has not only led you to each other, but to this very moment. And that's what the unity candle will represent later on in the ceremony. How your two individual lives will now become one through marriage. And if there's a few things that I hope would carry along its way with the two of you throughout your journey together, it would be for you both to always be willing, from the heart, to listen, learn, and to love. And by that I simply mean for you both to always be willing to listen to the other. What it is that they have to offer, and what makes them feel whole and complete and part of this relationship, this marriage the two of you are now creating. Because after all, they just may be the voice of reason. And secondly, is the ability to learn. Now, no matter the place and time, always be willing to learn whatever it takes to help the other fulfill every desire, every wish, every dream, and goal that they may have. And lastly, but most importantly, is the ability to love. To love one another unconditionally, which means no strings attached. It's an ongoing love. And this is the type of love that I hope the two of you would wish to express to one another each and every day. Keeping in mind, Jeff, that Kiana's happiness will always be far more important than your own. And also, Kiana, that Jeff's happiness will be important as well. And the reason for that is, with that in your minds and in your hearts, I have no doubt that your lives together will be everything that you want it to be. So with that said, sir, I'll ask you first, with your presence here today, alongside Kiana, do you take her as your wife and promising to love, honor, cherish, and respecting her always, allowing nothing or no one to ever come between the two of you? Do you take her as your wife, sir?
I do.
Thank you. And Kiana, I'll ask you the same. With your presence here today, alongside Jeff, do you take him as your husband in promising to love, honor, cherish, and respecting him always, allowing nothing or no one to ever come between the two of you? Do you take him as your husband?
I do.
Thank you. And if I could have your bouquet, please. Thank you. I'll ask for the two of you to turn and face each other and hold each other's hands. And as you look into each other's eyes, you will see the very reason of what brought you here today, proving that at this moment, there is no one more important than who stands before you. So Jeff, as you look into her eyes, I'll have you repeat your vows. I, Jeff, take you, Kiana.
I, Jeff, take you, Kiana.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I will always be there for you.
I will always be there for you.
Through the good times and the bad.
For the good times and the bad.
Whether we are rich or poor.
Whether we are rich or poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Through laughter and tears.
Through laughter and tears.
I will love and cherish you.
I will love and cherish you.
I give you my pledge.
I give you my pledge.
Thank you, sir. Now, Kiana, as you look into Jeff's eyes, I'll have you repeat your vows. I, Kiana, take you, Jeff.
I, Kiana, take you, Jeff.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I will always stand beside you.
I will always stand beside you.
Through success and misfortune.
Through success and misfortune.
Through the joys and sorrows of life.
Through the joys and sorrows of life.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Through laughter and tears.
Through laughter and tears.
I'll love and cherish you.
I love and cherish you.
I give you my pledge.
I give you my pledge.
Thank you, Kim. Now the rings that I have here, they will seal this commitment. And they're not only tokens, but symbols of the very love and devotion that the two of you are expressing here today. And my hope is that in each and every day, with the two of you wearing these rings, may they constantly remind you of that promise and pledge that you've just made to one another. And in time, the rings themselves may lose beauty, but I hope that the two of you would not only value, but take honor in wearing these rings for what they truly represent. And through your friends and family, the beauty will shine through you both, and the two of you will always remain a wonderful example to all. So Jeff, as you place the ring upon her ring finger, if you would please repeat,
with this ring,
I seal my promise.
I seal my promise.
To be your faithful and loving husband.
To be your faithful and loving husband.
And I am so honored.
And I am so honored.
To call you my wife.
To call you my wife.
Thank you, sir. Okay. As you place the ring upon his ring finger, if you would please repeat, with this ring.
With this ring.
I seal my promise.
I seal my promise.
To be your faithful and loving wife.
To be your faithful and loving wife.
And I am so honored.
And I am so honored.
To call you my husband.
To call you my husband.
And at this time, if I could ask for the two of you to step over behind the unity candle. Now, as I mentioned earlier, the two of you have each had a separate path that has led you to this very point. And it's the individually lit tapers that are representing your individual lives. And in lighting the center candle, you will not only be uniting yourselves, but that of your families as well. So I'll ask for the two of you to take a hold of your individual taper, and if you could light the center candle at the same time, which is also symbolizing the creation of a new journey with new memories. And once lit, I'll ask for the two of you to turn and blow out your individual taper. Thank you. At this time, I would like you guys back to the front. Now, Jeff, Kian, if you love someone, you'd be loyal to them no matter what the cost. You'll always stand beside them. You'll always love and trust them. And you will stand your ground in defending them no matter what. Now, there's a short saying that I'd like to leave with the two of you. And it simply says, don't walk in front of me. I may not follow. Don't walk behind me. I may not lead, but walk beside me as a friend. Because after all, throughout your journey together in marriage, that is what the two of you will be constantly building on, is a deeper, richer, stronger friendship built upon the foundation, your wonderful relationship that the two of you already have. And I'd also hope that the two of you would not only love each other for who they are, but what they are also helping to make of you. Now, it certainly has been a joy to be part of this celebration with you both. And the 8th of February, a day that will now mark your anniversary. And with the authority vested in me by the state of Nevada, with the two of you showing your intentions by the exchanging of your vows and the exchanging of your rings, it is my honor and my privilege to now be able to pronounce you as husband and wife. Jeff, you may now kiss your wife, sir. Oscar, that you could turn to face your photographer. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Thompson, the newlyweds. Congratulations, you two.
Thank you.